this video, we are to discuss problems relating to the capital gain, and especially we are going to do problems relating to short-term capital gain. Okay, so let us see the problems relating to the short-term capital gain calculation. First, whether it is short term or long term will be decided by POHA. So it may be any question relating to the capital gain. First, we some points we need to identify in the problem. So what are those means? First thing we need to identify nature of capital asset, which type of capital asset it is. Is it shares or is it relating to land or building, whether movable property or gold, jewelry, like this. Because based on that itself, we have to consider the period of holding. So first thing is nature of capital asset. Capital asset kaun sa hai? So capital asset and then POHA, these two will decide whether it is short term capital asset, period of holding of an asset, whether short term capital asset or long term capital asset. Then for deciding POHA, we need to check these things: date of transfer, date of acquisition. Date of transfer means the date on which we have sold the asset, and date of acquisition, when we have purchased. Suppose it is immovable property, we need to consider, in case of immovable property, we need to consider less than 24 months short term, more than 24 months long term. Less than 24 months short term, more than 24 months long term. So date of transfer means the data, and date of acquisition means date of purchase. These three two things will decide the period of holding of an asset. Okay, if period of holding of asset in case of financial assets less than 12 months, it will be considered it as short term. For some financial assets we will consider, for some unlisted shares we need to consider 24 months. So that whether it is short term or long term will be decided based on the period of holding and nature of asset. So those two things we need to remember. And next point is cost of acquisition. In case of immovable properties and other things, cost of improvement, these two things we need to consider. And if it is long term, we will do indexation. For that we need to see the CII. Okay, so these are the things. And in special cases, advance money, forfeited and other things will be there. In case of land and building, please be careful with regard to the stamp duty value calculations also. For others, that much not important. In case of immovable property, we need to consider those. And one more thing, we need to identify transfer expenses. Transfer expenses, that is selling expenses, we will take these also. And exemption, which exemption is applicable in this question, that we need to consider. So points we need to identify in a problem, first of all, while doing the problem. So while reading, we need to underline these points. After that, we can easily do the problem. We can solve the problem. So let us see one by one. Now we are going to see some questions related to the short-term capital gain. So why I am saying short-term capital gain? Because I already identified these things. So first we are going to see the question number 23. Which one we are doing? Question number 23. This is the question number 23 we are having on the screen here. Hope you all can see it. If I increase the size, okay. So here we are having question number 30. For immovable property, period of holding of an asset less than 12 months short term capital asset. If period of holding is greater than, then it will be greater than 12. In case of immovable property, it should be 24 months greater than 24 months will be long term capital asset. So first thing we need to identify, flat means capital asset. That capital asset which, if it is held by SSC for more than 24 months, we need to consider it as long term. Previously 36 months were there, now it is only 24 months. So please, as per the new assessment year 1920, we need to consider. So this is nothing but cost of acquisition, COA, cost of purchase. Kitne mein purchase kare ye? He has purchased for 14,50,000 in Krishna Apartments Dwaraka on date 2nd November 2016. Please remember 2016 they are saying. Okay. In next small print mistake, please correct it. You make it 2016. Okay. In textbook there is a print mistake. I am saying maybe written as 2015. You correct it as 2016. Okay. She to Radha on 3rd July 2018. 3rd July 2018. Are less than 24 months, will decide whether it is short term or long term, and based on that we will calculate short term capital gain and long term capital gain. So selling expenses are given 11,000 rupees. Cost of inflation index is 280 for the assessment for the financial year 18-19. Compute income from capital gain for the current assessment year. Your current assessment year is what? 2019-20. So first, period of holding, how many months from the date of transfer, date of purchase to date of transfer, date of purchase or date of acquisition, both one and the same. So date of acquisition or purchase is when 2nd November, they are saying 2016. थर्ड जुलाई 2018. सो नवंबर 2 नवंबर 2016 टू 2017 12 मंथ्स. इफ यू गेट अनदर नवंबर 2018, इफ इट इज सेकंड नवंबर अगेन और फर्स्ट नवंबर एटलीस्ट टिल फर्स्ट नवंबर 2018, डू वी हैव इट? नो, वी हैव सोल्ड द असेट ऑन 3rd जुलाई 2018. सो पीरियड ऑफ होल्डिंग इज हाउ मेनी मंथ्स? सो फ्रॉम 2016 टू 2017 नवंबर इट इज 12 मंथ्स. देन लेटर डिसंबर जनवरी 2018, राइट? आफ्टर डिसंबर नवंबर डिसंबर 2017 डिसंबर जनवरी फिब्रवरी मार्च अप्रैल मई जून जुलाई. सो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is 8 + 12, 20 months period the assessee is holding the asset. If it is period of holding is less than 24 months in case of immovable property, then it will be considered as short-term capital asset. On transfer of short-term capital asset, you will get short-term capital gain. Please understand this point. First thing, this is very important thing. Okay. Remaining things, like this is date of, this is cost of purchase, that is nothing but your cost of acquisition, and this is full value of consideration, sale value, full value of consideration, transfer expenses 11,000. In case of short term capital asset, we will consider only cost of acquisition, no indexation will be done. So let us see problem related answer. So answer relating to this, we are going to see. And thank you for the students who has provided these notes, our class notes it is. So we are having the here answer, question number 23. Don't worry. So here we are having some. Okay, now it is appearing clearly. It is appearing clearly now. Computation of total income and tax liability. Computation of total income and tax liability. Here he didn't ask about tax liability. सॉरी, ही हैज आस्क्ड अस टू कैलकुलेट इनकम फ्रॉम कैपिटल गेन. सो कंप्यूटेशन ऑफ इनकम फ्रॉम कैपिटल गेन ऑफ श्रीमती रुक्मिणी फॉर द असेसमेंट ईयर 1920, आई टोल्ड यू टू राइट शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल गेन. Value was 16 lakhs. Selling expenses, transfer expenses 11,000. If you deduct, then you will get net consideration A minus B 15,89,000. From that, cost of acquisition. Cost of acquisition is what? Cost of purchase. Is asset is purchased on or after 1/4 2000? So after 1/4 2001, here we need to write calculation of cost of acquisition. They wrote shortcuts. Capital asset purchased after 1/4 2001. Cost of acquisition equals to cost of purchase. This should be note point. So cost of acquisition is cost of purchase, that is 14,50,000. From 15,39,000, if you deduct 14,50,000, short term capital gain before exemptions, there is no cost of improvement to the asset, so that is nil. So short term capital gain before exemption is 1,39,000. Exemption under section 54 are not there, so nil. Short term capital gain, taxable short term capital gain is how much? 1,39,000. As there is no other income, your income is less than basic exemption limit of 2,50,000, it is not taxable also. But in the question, he has asked only to calculate short term capital gain. So we have calculated short term capital gain. That's it. Very simple one. But period of holding of asset, we need to write one more point relating in these notes. In the notes, we need to write one more point which I already explained at the beginning of the problem itself. Period of holding of capital asset, that is flat, immovable property by assessee is 20 months. So capital asset will be considered as short term capital asset, and the resultant gain on transfer is short term capital gain. Resultant gain on transfer is short term capital gain. This is what one more point you need to add so that you can get O instead of A. Everyone will solve the problem, but those who will write extra points will get O in the exam instead of A. Because the points are very important for the answer. So in class we wrote many note points. Some problems you might have not written, as you already aware that exam mein likhenge bolke nahi likhe, isliye notes mein ye point yahan pe nahi aaya. Koi baat nahi. So this is what we need to do. Let us see one more question relating to this. So previously we did one question relating to what? Flat. Now there is one more question. Mr. Jimmy purchased equity shares of a listed equity shares. In case of listed equity shares, if STT paid, if STT paid listed equity shares, if STT paid short term capital gain is taxable at the rate 15% under section 111A, and in case of long term capital gain listed equity shares, if STT paid and transferred in a recognized stock exchange, is taxable at the rate 10% above 1 lakh. Do you remember this one? Above 1 lakh. Up to 1 lakh it is not taxable. Above 1 lakh it is taxable. Under section 112A, this is the new section. We have discussed how to calculate about this also. So these are the things. Let us see what about this question. Why I wrote all these points means, while looking at the question itself, you should get the concept relating to that. So पहले क्वेश्चन पढ़ते वक्त ही आपको हाँ ये वाला प्रॉब्लम है तो ऐसा ऐसा करना है बोल के आपको दिमाग में आ जाना, मतलब कि ब्रेन लो अच्छे से लेदी शॉर्ट टर्म लॉन्ग टर्म, शॉर्ट टर्म आते इतना इसकोले, लॉन्ग टर्म आते इतना इसकोले, लाइक ओके लेट अस सी. जिम्मी परचेस्ड इक्विटी शेयर्स ऑफ लिस्टेड ऑफ ए लिमिटेड कंपनी ऑन 14th December 2018. व्हेन ही हैज परचेस्ड December 2018 for 2,80,000. On March, देखो here also there is a print mistake. If you purchase in December 2018, how can you sell in March 2018? So if it is March 2018, it will not come in our financial year, so it should be March 2019. Make a correction for that. March 2019 he has sold. December 2018 aayega. December 2018 means it should be March 2019. So on March 2019 sold the same for 3,50,000. The cost of inflation index for 2018-19 is 280. ये क्रीम बिस्किट है, इससे कुछ भी लेना देना नहीं. Because when you have purchased in December, you have purchased December, January, December 2018, January 2019, February 2019. February 2019, March 2019. So how many months? 1, 2, 3, 4 months it is totally. So period of hold in case of listed shares, in case of listed equity shares, period of holding greater than FOHA, greater than 12 months long term, less than 12 months short term. So here period of holding is only 4 months, it is short कैपिटल असेट ऑन ट्रांसफर ऑफ शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल असेट यू विल गेट शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल गेन। ओके तो प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट एंड डू दी प्रॉब्लम अकॉर्डिंग। आई विल नॉट टेल दी आंसर रिलेटिंग टू इट, यू नीड टू डू इट ओके बाई यूर सेल्फ, टेक इट एज ए होमवर्क। हाँ, इट इज ए शॉर्ट टर्म वन, सेम प्रीवियस प्रॉब्लम हाउ वी डिड। यू आर हैविंग सेल वैल्यू 3,50,000, देर इज नो ट्रांसफर एक्सपेंसेस सेलिंग एक्सपेंसेस, सो नेट कंसिडरेशन 3,50,000, देन कास्ट ऑफ एक्विजिशन 2,80,000। फ्रॉम 3,50,000 इफ यू डिडक्ट 2,80,000, 70,000 is your short term capital gain. That is what you need to do. And there is no exemption under section 54 EC also or any other section also. So your short term capital gain is 70,000. That's it. Calculate capital gain, he asked. So 70,000 capital gain short term will you will get. So do by yourself, because we are going to do a problem better than this. And before that, let us see one more question relating to this 21. During the previous year, relevant to the current assessment year, Mr. Quick purchased a house. House means immovable property. 24 months होने चाहिए। If it is less than 24 months, you need to consider it as short term. Less than रहा तो less than 24 months, less than 24 months. Okay, quick purchased a house for 4,20,000. This is cost of purchase. That is nothing but your cost of acquisition. Okay, and after 12 months, after 12 months, please, कितने months के बाद? 12 मंथ्स के बाद सोल्ड द सेम हाउस फॉर 4,80,000। कितने में सेल कर दिए? 4,80,000। दिस इज योर सेल वैल्यू, दैट इज योर फुल वैल्यू ऑफ कंसिडरेशन। ब्रोकरेज पेड ऑन परचेज ऑफ 10,000 एंड सेल ऑफ हाउसेस 18,000। दिस 18,000 ट्रांसफर एक्सपेंसेस एंड दिस 10,000 is cost of brokerage paid on purchase of house will be included in cost of purchase. Okay, so cost of acquisition is equals to cost of purchase plus brokerage on purchase. So 4,20,000 plus 10,000, 4,30,000 will be your cost of acquisition that you need to consider. Here it is 12, not more than 24 months, so it is a short term capital asset. So same thing, previous problem we did many same like you need to do for this one also. This is also homework problem. Take it for homework, I am saying. So here I am in short term capital gain. सीखना बन तो जीतना बन, सीखते रहो जीतने के लिए। डू दी टू प्रॉब्लम्स विच आई गेव एज होमवर्क फॉर द रिविजन पर्पज। दिस टाइप प्रॉब्लम्स विल बी आस्क्ड एज ए शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन इन द एग्जाम। जय हिंद।